Hello. Right. What is up, everyone? Hey, what's up, Q? I made it back. All right. Oh, so I thought I would make a game in this stream, just from scratch, just a quick little game in Construct 3. Ran a poll earlier, and most votes went to create a game on stream. So that is what I'm going to do tonight. Oh, man. I still cannot get over whatever this is in my head. Ugh. Okay, let's see here. What kind of game? You know, I have never played around with the car behavior. I don't think I've ever made a car game. So, I think I am going to make a car game. And let's do a 720. Get a little small. Sure, why not? All right. Oh man. So, Q Merc, what's going on, man? A little fuel. I really gotta stop drinking those. Racing game or a parking game or what kind? I was thinking racing. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, or I don't know. I don't know. I did not prepare for this. Not much, just sitting watching YouTube. Right on. That's what I was doing. Instead of preparing for what kind of game I was going to make. All right. I'm going to make that transparent. I'm going to make me another layer. Let's set up a car. So I think I'm just going to do everything inside Construct 3. Let's see, I'm at a 720, so let's see what 150, maybe? And we'll put that in the middle for now. And we'll give it a color. Let's go red. About as ugly as I can make it. You were getting bored with what you're watching? Yeah. Man, that's really not hard to do if you're on YouTube long enough. All right. So there's our little... Okay. I think that's a decent size. Let's shoot for a racing game for right now. We can change it later because we're complete control. Car. Add. Okay. I'm going to... Oh. Let's see. Max speed. Default controls, so arrow keys, I assume. Ah, fancy. That's not bad. I would like to figure out how to add more drift. Get that tail end drifting. And deceleration probably needs to go up quite a bit. Drift recover. Oh, cool. It's built in. No kidding. The rate and angle of motion catches up with the object angle. Lower values cause drifting, higher values cause tighter turns. Okay, fair enough. And we have friction as well. That'll be helpful. I can't believe I have never played with this this behavior before. This is kind of cool. And oh my goodness, my stream elements seems it might be working. That was quite the struggle last stream. I didn't know it had a car behavior. No, it's not new. It's been in Construct 3, I think, since I ever started in Construct 3, which I think I'm going on about 4 years now. And I've always seen it there. I've just never done anything with it. So I'm going to make deceleration. I'm going to go up a little bit. Steer speed. I think steer speed's probably fine for right now. Drift recover. Let's go down. Let's see what that does. Oh, yes. Oh, that's nice. Okay, maybe the friction. Can't wait to see what the drift does. Man, I'm excited about that. I agree. I cannot believe I haven't done anything with this yet. Let's go 0.8. We'll double the friction. And it looks like my stream elements automated messages are very close together. I'll have to change that too. That's all right. Quite the learning process. I like the drift. I feel like the recover's still a little much. The friction. What is the friction for? Amount of slowdown when hitting solids. Oh. Well, that doesn't affect me at all then, right now. Turn while stopped. Nah. Stream Elements is on a mission. I had a talk with them after that last stream. So, they better be on a mission. I wonder if the deceleration... No. I don't think that would make it. Yeah, I... That... Oh. Come back. Come back. Where are you? There you are. Okay, deceleration. Let's go 600. If I had ever played with this mechanic before, I don't think I'd have to do all this. That's not bad. I don't like that sideways movement after the drift ends. Drift recover. I'm just going to go down to like 30 and see what that does. A drift track. See, that's what I was kind of thinking, like with some tight turns so you have to drift around corners. And then maybe if you run into barriers, it slows you down or something. And no, it's a... Ah, okay. Boy, there's going to be a sweet spot there. Let's say drift recover. Go back to 100. What was that like? Oh no. I wonder how that acceleration needs to go up though. We'll bump the max speed up to 400 as well. And I'll double the acceleration for deceleration. Let's go 0.2. Let's see if that makes any difference, the friction. I also think that the image point might benefit from being at the front. But maybe back a few. Let's see what that does. Guess I could save. Not in there. I was right. Go back. Let's do new folder. There we go. Car game. We'll say car game _01. There we go. See, I like your idea about getting points for drifting in a certain way. Call it Vroom Vroom. Well, we will make a title screen for it. So far, Vroom Vroom is at the top of the list for names. That's kind of... just that recovery. I just don't know what to... I want to say... Okay, let's go up then. Let's go up and see what that does. That's not bad. Okay. I'm satisfied for right now. That's what I'm going to do. Okay. All right. Let's make some track pieces. I'm going to name this track. Is it able to register when you're drifting, or does it think it's a normal turn? Huh. That's a good question. And I don't know. Does it think it's a normal turn? I think what it's doing is it's keeping the momentum while rotating the object and then like gradually reducing the momentum to the other direction, if I had to take a guess. And that might not be what you're asking at all, but I'm very interested to learn how this works, especially what changes we can do to it in the event sheet. I'm going to go into our track, and I want a tile map. That's what I'm going to do. Let's see. How about... let's do 128 by 128. What is my stream elements doing? Uh, My stream elements just removed all of your comments. How do you undo that? Did it delete them all on your end too? Oh my god, why did it do that? Okay, listen here, stream elements. You need to chill on that. If you wanted to earn points or something for when you're drifting, and then no points when you're not. Oh, yeah. I bet that could be set up. I bet so. I bet there's a way to tell when that kind of movement is happening. I sure would like to know why. That happened. I have no idea. Sorry, everybody. I'm just you just got timed out? What the heck? I can see your messages on my end, but it shows that Stream Elements removed every single one of them. Time out. Where did I set that out? Set that up. Maybe it was paragraph. Oh, I bet that's what it was. Did it tell you what you were timed out for? Oh my god, that's okay. I just undid that paragraph, so maybe that was it. That's very strange. Just got timed out. Good lord. All right. I hope that fixes things. Okay. Let's go to our grid. I'm going to do 64 by 64. It was probably spam. Oh, maybe. Maybe it did. Okay, well, that's another thing that I need to look up. Where's my... Oh. My little note-taking section here. Man, I'm sorry about that. I mean, it's how I have it set up. I guess I didn't realize that it was that strict on it. That's weird, but I turned that off, so hopefully that doesn't happen again. Ugh. Hopefully. All right. No spam is good. Well, I mean, I don't think that was really spam. But I guess my opinion did not matter, according to Stream Elements. Let's see here. Take the saturation down. A little brighter. Give this a little dirt path. And I think We'll do a straightaway. And let's see. Fill. Wait, that's ugly. Maybe it's the hue. Yeah, I'm going with it. I will forget how you treated me. Fair. Fair enough. Man. Tough crowd. Okay, I really have no idea what I'm doing here. This is the part where not being very good at any kind of art just sucks. I'm just gonna do like a little. Let's do it like this. Well, that's the same color. Let's do a white. Already messed it up. Okay. That's fine. My poor dog has not been feeling very well today. She is in her little bed down there. She is not having it. The Night Renegade. You know how much time I spent making that animation before I recorded those videos? Like, that was difficult for me. I made that in Ace Sprite, or however you pronounce it. But man, that took a while. Oh. Okay, looks kind of like a turn, huh? Oops. I don't know. I don't want to spend too much time on it, so I'm gonna go with that. And I will leave these two there, so if we need to change it later, we can, or add something. And I'll leave it like that for the moment. I need my tile map, which I think I have down here. I do. Let's see if this is even a good size. I'd have to go too wide, and then yeah, that looks awkward. Huh. All right. Well, I learned. So let's make this 256. By 256. There we go. I'll fill that, and then let's try this again. Let's go with a circle. And let's see, from the edge, might have to move it. Oh, why? No border. Let's see if it works like this. Something like that, maybe? to get rid of that. Hey, I copied you. Man. I gotta do it again. Okay. I think something like that. Let's do it differently this time. You don't want to cooperate. Maybe like that. Oh my. There we go. Okay. Now I can just fill in these spots. Except for that one up there. Oh my god, why did I do that? I'm not even paying attention. Get it together. Okay. Let's see if that works. And I will get... There we go. Let's change these to... What did I do? 128? 128 by 128? Is that? You gotta be kidding me. Oh, sure it is. Oh, what happened here? Okay, I think that's manageable. We'll try it. Actually, it's gonna do it like that, and then what is the size of that? 47. Let's go to 47. Actually, that won't matter, will it? If I'll put a camera on this. And we're going forever. Okay, it does matter. So let's do... No, not 400, 4,000. Okay. Let's make us a nice little background so I can see what I'm doing. Nope. Tiled background. Let's see here. Let's make it 100 by 100. Just so it kind of offsets our tile map. And then I'll do these 50 by 50. And let's get us a nice dark color. So lighter color. And we will copy you. Cannot see the boundaries. I think that covers everything. We shall find out. All right, now we can tell that we're moving. All right. Cool. Okay. I'm going with it. I'm going to put this somewhere over here, lock that, and let's get our track. Okay. Is that? Why? Oh my gosh, did I really? Oops. Okay. Wonder if that shows up. Rendered. Oh, we're gonna have to go a lot faster. Oh, that's the edge of the map. Okay. I gotcha. Okay. Whoops. There we go. Okay. Yeah. I guess I'm just gonna do it like that then. It's going to need a much wider for drifting. And then we will, let's do this again. I need to turn you. There we go. Let's see. I have no idea if this is going to work out at all. Oh, let's make it a really tight turn here. Okay. You know, I really didn't even need these. In fact, I think I'm just going to leave that out of the tile map. And let's bump his max speed up. Oh. Okay. Oh boy. Okay, maybe a little faster. Uh-oh, let's try that again. Donuts. Okay. A little faster. Steer speed. I'm going to go down a little. Let's say 210. And drift recover. Yeah. Deceleration. Bump that up a little. Yeah, I don't like the deceleration is not very good. Okay. That's not bad. Ooh, that was a nice drift, huh? That's not bad. For right out of the box, I have not written a line of code yet. That's pretty cool. All right. Let's see here. While I am thinking about it, let's go to the track. Um, 128, I believe it's, there we go. I'm going to do a checker. Tokyo Drive. Better believe it. Vroom, vroom, drifter. I like it. Let's see. I knew what you meant. That looks good. Okay. I do like the origin point being up there. I think that made a difference. I'm going to come back a little more, though. Let's try that. And get us some little headlights going on here. Like that. Really should have the guides on. Tokyo Drift Vroom Vroom Edition. If it wasn't for... what am I trying to say? the rights to the name of Tokyo Drift, I think you're onto something. not like anybody's ever going to see it. Copyright. Jeez. Man. Don't know what I would do without you in these streams. Okay. Let's see. I think I'm going to... Let's see. I'll add some tires. Let's go back down. All right. Oh, what? What are you doing? Okay. Let's paste another one. Put it up there somewhere. Looks good to me. All right, fancy, very fancy. Let's make it even fancier. Yeah. Taxi service. That works too. Taxi service, go vroom vroom. Is that right? That looks even. Good enough for me. Marlin's Taxi Service. There we go. Look at that fanciness. All right. That moment I realized, you and me both. I'm all hopped up on energy drinks over here. All right. Deceleration is, I don't know what's going on here. Let's go 2000. Thing just rolls. Okay. Okay. I like it. Okay. I'm happy with that. Deceleration. I think maybe acceleration up just a little bit. Okay. We can come back to that. Actually looks fun already. Man, I'm telling you, I'm having fun with it. I'm very impressed with Construct 3's built-in car behavior. I had no idea. Oh, okay. Go back to my track. I'm going to touch this up just a little. Let's go there. No, let's do that way. Like that. Okay. All right. I think once we get it down, we could probably make the track bigger. There we go. Alrighty. Let's set up. Oh, we could do like a rough area around. Let's do that. I'm going to take this out. We do not need it. That was a bad idea. Let's make it greenish. Oh. What happened? There we go. Let's come down. Take that saturation down, down, down. Luminance. Almost gray, huh? That's what I think. That's what I'm going with. A pit stop to refuel. That's not a bad idea. I like that. I don't know if I'll get that in one stream's time. I do like that, though. That is a good idea. It would add some strategy. Ooh. I believe in you. See, now I'm over-scoping already because now I won't be able to do it this stream, but we could test the peer-to-peer multiplayer in the future. And we could make a long track where multiple people could race. That'll take some work, but I like that idea. See, that is how quickly overscope happens. It would be. It's I have been wanting to test out the multiplayer capabilities that are built in to Construct 3. And I've researched it a little, but I've not done anything with it yet. I think that would be fun. What happened to my music? There it is. All right. Okay, that's good. I'll do an extra padding over here, and here, and here. Let's do one more. Okay. Let's go back. Let's save. Save. Always save. They are 128 by 128, yes. I'm in a 720. My viewport's 7, what is it? Yeah, 1280 by 720. So an SD, or I'm sorry, HD, standard HD. Not the full HD. I want some kind of track separator. I have no idea what I'm doing here. Let's do center. I don't know. Something like that. Something like that. Let's see if that works. I want a barrier. And I think what I have done... Oh, yeah. There's transparency in that. I think I need to... move this out a little. So, do that. Yeah, so I can put a separator right down there and we can still hit the rough patch. And let's make this an even tighter turn like that. Just got a notification that I'm going to stream live tomorrow. Is that this stream? Oh, yeah, it's the stream. Yeah, did it just now pop up? Looks like my other YouTube account that I monitor my stream with has not received a notification either. So, yeah, that's got to be for this stream. I haven't set another one up in YouTube. I don't know why it would send out a notification for another one. So, yeah, that's got to be. That's, huh. Interesting. Not really. It seems very YouTube-like. Yeah. That's a little strange, huh? Let's see here. I am going to... let's get out of this. I want a new object. And I'll make it 64 by 64. And I'll do a 32 by 32. And let's get a different... What do we want that color? I mean, I could use that blue. I'm going to use the blue. And, yeah, we'll stay in the center. Oh, nope. Let's reverse that. It's going to be off center. And this side. Yeah. Yeah. Oh my. Nope. Nope. solid black. Let's fill that. Eh, whatever. Works for me. origin point. No, in the middle. And, oh, the box. Yeah. Let's go 4x4, snap to edge. Just get this closer. Yeah, it's fine. Wait. Cool. Okay. You know what? I think I'm just going to copy that. And I'm going to make a... Let's call this barriers. And that'll be above our track. And we will go get us another tile map. And let's do... What? Oh, wrong one. 64x64. Clear. Paste. Done. And make sure we cover everything. Do, 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 64x64. Not trying to get too fancy. Does that... It's not lined up. Okay. Let's go 0, 0. There we go. And then, whoops, misclicking. This needs to be, I mean, this needs to be 0, 0 also. So that kind of messes with things. That's fine. We will adjust by going 6,000x6,000, because we can do whatever we want. And to the background, cover that up. Back to the barriers. Oh, I'm going to get rid of Sprite 2. Let's call this Tile Barrier. Wait, that is ugly. That is ugly. Let's just make it white. And flood fill off. Fill the whole thing. Nice. Okay. What am I missing here? Because... let's count. What is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Maybe it was supposed to be 128, huh? Yeah. Let's go find out. What am I doing here? I want to change the size. Where's my... I can't change the size? Really? Huh. Preview. Preview what? Strange. Okay. I'm just gonna delete it. Let's try again. I'm gonna go tile map. Let's make it 128 by 128. Clear. Configure 64 by 64. And let's do it like that. Oh. No snap. Okay. That's good. Let's make it something like that. That's what I'm going with. And I'm leaving it like that. Or should I? Yeah, because I'm going to put a collision on this tile map, so it will need to be the full size, won't it? Oh, but I don't want them. Okay. We'll just go in a little bit. Like that. So that should separate them. And go 128 by 128. Get our... That's what I want. Ugly, but that's how I do it. Yeah. Okay, I'm leaving it. And then I'll just make a barrier. Okay, 1, 2, 3, good. I don't know why that looks off to me. That's fine. Okay. Save that. Go back to car. Put him there. And we'll just see what it looks like. There's no functionality to it yet. Good enough for me. Cool. We're going to have to make another one. This will be, I'll just call it rough. Rough. Put it below track. Okay. And go back to my track. And I'm going to erase. Doc's favorite layer. I like it. There we go. Save that, and then go to my rough. Let's do another tile map. And I can make this one 128 by 128. We'll clear that. And I'm going to go get that. Oh, okay. Yeah, it's still there. I'm gonna sample the color. Go back in here and fill it. Let's do 128 by 128. Sweet. So if I make the tile map separate for each one, and it's just going to make it easier to apply collisions for detection. I could do it all on one tile map, but there's extra steps involved to figure out which part of the tile map you're using. I don't want to deal with that. So, tile map 2. Tile barrier. Let's give it a behavior of solid. And I think that's it. We'll have to code the roughness. Okay, let's go to the event sheet. Actually, let's add a keyboard. Keyboard. Now let's go. Keyboard. On key is down. Let's choose the W key. And let's make that bigger. And let's figure this out. I should have renamed that. Let's go to the car. Lots of stuff for the car. Nice. Okay. Set acceleration, default controls, set speed. simulate control. Accelerate. Oh, we can do a brake, too. Maybe. I guess we could. Oh, my gosh. I hate that about the event sheet. We'll call this car. And that works. Cool. Let's do A. And D. And yeah, we can do a whoops. Nope. There we go. Let's do a S. We'll do that for break. Might take that out. D is to the right. A is to the left. And I'm going to deselect default controls because I am tired of using arrow keys. And I need to change that as well. Okay, cool. Oh, it's reverse. I gotcha. Okay. Is that the deceleration? Nope. Yeah, I don't know about that. We'll come back to it. Okay. Let's test the, okay, cool. I think that's where friction comes in. The amount of slowdown when hitting solids between 0 and 1. So if we did 1, it should stop it, right? Get some speed. It does. Okay. Okay, I am going to need the brake. That's going to have to be a separate state so that it does not... Because I think it's using deceleration as the reverse speed. And I do not want that. So we'll have to change that. I'll work on that in a little bit. Let's figure out a good... let's try 6. Go, buddy, go. All right. We'll do that for debugging purposes. Okay, that's not bad. That would need that acceleration to come down. If it's going to be... a friction like that. There we go. It's a little bit slower startup once you hit a barrier. I wonder if you can drift into it if it doesn't. Doesn't affect it much when you drift into a solid. But that's okay. I don't hate it. I'm going to go 0.7. Just make it a little challenging. Okay. S is down. Let's say... I wonder if we can check the velocity. Oh, that would be in an event... compare speed. Nice. Yes. I'm going to need that. I feel like I would like a... a reverse... key and just use S for brake and space for reverse. So much for keeping it simple. Okay, let's say compare speed is greater than 0. Or let's just make it 1. And let's do the space key. Then we can set deceleration. Um I put an image point between the front wheels and the car was handled more pleasantly. Are you saying like at the very front? Because I have it towards the front, but a little bit. Oh, you're saying right between the wheel part? You could rotate the car a couple times after hitting a barrier. Oh, yeah. From the wall, act like it spun out. Yes, I like that. I'll move it up to where the tires are. I think that's makes a little sense. That's a good call. And let's see. Space is down. How would we do this? I think we'd still have to set it to brake and set the deceleration to let's do 200. We don't want it going too fast. Else, let's do an else. If it is greater, let's see. No, that would be less than one. This would be less than one. Else, if it's greater than one, then car pressing brake and deceleration back to 2000. That's gonna run into no, that should work. And so, okay, that breaks it. Okay, cool. That works. And there's reverse. Little fast. Space is down. I think we might need to do that there. Space is not down. Set our deceleration back to 2000. Okay, there. It doesn't keep going. That brakes pretty good. Let's see, let's get up some speed here. I want if it's less than yeah. Okay. I'm just gonna go with it. I don't want to get too detailed. I want to be able to complete this in a short amount of time. See, this is good practice for overscoping, because I'm really trying to keep myself from coming up with new little mechanics. Okay, let's add an event and say overlapping tile map 3. Let's rename tile map 3 to tile underscore dog's favorite tile map. Tile map. Let's rename that to tile underscore track. tiles. let's just say objects. There we go. Uh-oh, where did I put it? In input. That's not right. Okay. When we are overlapping the rough. Do you like that? Rough. Let's set max speed. Objects, car. Set max speed to let's try 200 and let's else we'll set it to what do we have 800 oh not 8000 And oh, it's a little abrupt. Huh. Oops. Let's see here. How would I get it to slowly go down to that max speed? I have to use subtract from its speed. Right. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking I'm going to have to do. Like every X seconds or maybe even every tick while it's on the rough. Okay, we'll do that. So let's sub-event this. While it's overlapping the rough and our car is greater than, let's go 200 for right now. Okay, we can sub-event that again and say every tick and we will set max speed to let's see, can we do self dot what would that be? Car dot max speed minus 5. And then we will have to do the same thing. Well, no, because it'll have the acceleration whenever it leaves the rough. I'll never hear that. Word again the same way again. I think I'm in the same boat. My dog is passed out. Good for her. Okay, let's test this real quick. No. Okay, I didn't let's try that again. Car speed. Oh my god, I need to fix that too. I'm gonna do that right now. Letterbox integer, letterbox. Yeah, letterbox scale. There we go. Okay. Nope. Still have it set to be 200. Yeah, I'm just, I want to be able to, I'm testing to see if it will slow down using this. As long as I'm above 200 minus 5, seems, I don't know. It might be right. I just have it set too much. Okay, there's 800. See, it goes straight to 200 really fast. Let's say minus. Minus one? That's probably not going to make a difference. Yeah. Okay. New strategy. Let's say if I'm not, we can go ahead and add that. We can put our speed back. We'll have to probably change. I don't know. I'm going to work on this for a second. Car speed. Maybe it needs a variable. Let's set speed. Speed. I'll just call this speed max. Actually, I think I'll use that as a global variable. We'll say car speed. And then this is an experiment. Every tick set. Nope. Set the value of car speed to car dot car dot max speed. I don't know if this is going to make any sense or not. So let's say if car speed let's compare car speed is all greater than 200. Is overlapping. Oh, I have it right there. Oh, is that, that's what you were saying? I am sorry. I just wasn't paying any attention to what you said, which I should know better because you have helped me out the last two streams. Okay. So if we're overlapping the rough and we're still above 200 speed, then every tick, yeah, for sure, maybe several face palms right in a row. I deserve it. Maybe really hard. Okay, every tick, set that else. Okay, maybe that will work. Yes, it does, but not fast enough. So let's create another variable and say a rough slow down, and I'll make it 5, and I'll change this karma for time. yeah, that's a good point. Well deserved, I guess, huh? That's funny. Okay, rough slowdown. So I don't need car speed, global variable. Don't need this one either. Get that cleaned up a little. And let's test this slowdown. Ah, look at that. And then our acceleration takes care of the rest of it. Nice. Nice. Very cool. Very, very impressed with the car. Man, that's nice. I like that it works that way. That's a pretty good slowdown, too. Of course, you can take that corner and not lose out. Thanks. Okay. It's not bad. You know what? That origin point when I'm in reverse doesn't make any sense. Because when I try to turn, it's like I have a rear wheel drive, I guess. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. We'll call it rear wheel drive. All right. I'm happy with that so far. So now we can make the objective of the game. We could do some, how could we know if we're drifting? Let's see, it would be, is moving, yeah, and car, set speed, ignoring input, default controls, set acceleration, drift, recover. Yeah, I would need to know, it's here, it's the event, it's the check. So there isn't a built-in way to detect if we're drifting, which is what we were talking about earlier. Oh, God. Get that stuff out of my throat. Is moving. Huh. That does seem like a challenge. What else do we have? An invisible cone in front of the car, and when you drift, needs to touch a part on the inside of a turn. Inside part of a turn. Needs to touch. Trying to picture how that might work. Is there an angle of motion? There is not an angle of motion. That's what I need. I wonder. Because I could compare the angle that it's moving and compare that to the direction it's facing, then if those are not the same angles or within a certain angle of each other, then that would be drifting. But how can I tell? It's not built into the car. So I wonder if we could add, is the drift a button? It is automatic. It's just making a sharp turn and like the drift recover, I guess, is another version of friction, kind of is how it sounds to me. The drift recover, if I put the drift recover all the way to max, then we wouldn't drift at all. The car would just turn. So, you could control when you have drift. Yeah, you can control when you have drift recover. But I don't think you can detect when you are drifting. Built into the car behavior. Is that what you mean? If not, I'll probably figure it out in like 20 minutes from now. And then you'll have to put another facepalm in chat. The bullet, you could detect when you're pressing the drift button. Yeah. Yeah, could do that. Okay, we could do that. We could do that. So, I'm going to put that somewhere else. Do like okay, let's say no, the back seating has got me this far. No, I think having a button to tell the car when it's in a drift state. Back sitting in a racing game. Haha. Yeah. See what you did there. Man, you're on fire. You called out the rough and now the back seating. You on a roll. Oh, there, I did it. See? Car, roll, eh? Eh? It's a wild ride back there. I can only imagine. Can only imagine. I'm going to add a group so I can get some of this. Let's say... Steering. It's my little victory. Okay, steering. And then this is reverse or braking. Let's say brake and reverse. Nope, don't do that. There we go. That will be both of these. Close. This will be the doggy section. That did not do anything. Nope. What are you doing? What are you doing? Is that, yeah. For 2 hours, take a break, man. Well, to be fair, I did have it open before I started the stream. Okay, let's do a drifting group. Drift. And let's set up a key. On key is down. I'm going to make it the shift key. Oops, shift. Okay, shift is down. Then we will go get our set drift recover. Yeah. Drift recover. We'll make that one. What did I have it as? It's right there in front of me. 120. Let's go 120. Just realize your jokes are dad jokes. There's no going back from that. Once you make a few of those, it's all over, man. You'll be making those jokes for the rest of your life. The worst part is when you make the dad jokes and people just kind of like stare at you out of the corner of their eye. Let's do an else and set it to the rate the angle of motion catches up with the object angle. Lower values cause drifting, higher values cause tighter turns. So I'm going to go, this might be too much. I'm going to go 200. And then I'm the only one laughing. Yep. But I mean, I do the same thing, but I definitely think I'm super hilarious. So as far as I'm concerned, I think that's all that matters. Okay. We have no drift. So that works. And then there's my drift button. That works. I wonder. Huh. If I should do I could bump that up a little. It's nice when things work out, huh? See, there's a challenge already. I suck at driving top-down 2D car racing games. Okay, that's a little smoother, I feel. Oh, boy. See, now I have drift held down the whole time, but that's okay. Okay. I'm happy with that. Let's do an instance variable. Let's do a Boolean and say is drifting. Shift is down. We will set our Boolean to true. Else, false. All right. Right, let's see here. All right. Okay, if our drifting is true, let's see. What were we thinking? That there just be you get points for drifting? Is that kind of where we were? Let's see here. I'm gonna have to I think this is going to have to be a touch instead of a held down. So on pressed. You don't remember this drink, maybe? Okay, so that else statement won't be necessary. Let's see if I press it and we set it to true. Then we can do it that way. And then is drifting. Let's set it to, I guess we could time it. I'm going to try that. Let's go behavior. Let's add a timer. I'm going to points for drifting. I think that's what we were saying. I do think you are correct, but we're also just making this up as we go. 1 second, and we'll call this drift, and then on timer. Oh, you're not gonna auto complete it for me? That's wrong. On drift, we'll set that to false. So this is where we will put an else statement. Is drifting. And then we'll move that, get rid of that. Let's see if that works. Uh-oh. I think I might have messed it up. Oh, no, it's drifting. A little. Let's do... Let's do 2 seconds. There. That's a little better. Cool. That way... Now we have a way to detect if it is drifting. It took a while to figure out. It took you a while to figure it out. I'm just over here pressing buttons. So I'm going to have to debug that. Because I think I'm going to. I've had enough of my own facepalm moments for the night. I need somebody else to pick up the slack. Okay, it's not resetting. If it is pressed, set it to true. So if it is true, that all works so far. After 2 seconds of drift, when it's done, we set drift to false, which if drift is false. Oh, I don't, what? What's happening here? I don't think I need that. I don't know if that's gonna fix my problem. Uh-oh. Why? Hey, car. Where's my timer? Is timer in? Timers. Oh. Timer drift 0 of 2. Okay. Back up. Why does that say 0 of 2? Yeah, because my drift is permanently on right now. It's not changing. No. So, I mean, it's a triggered event, so it should only count once. How about if drifting is false? Drifting is false, and we shift. I can leave it up there, though. If it's false, we set it there. Then if we press shift, set it true. I'm going to take that back down to 1. Let's see if I am super smart. I seriously doubt it. Oh, I want my timer. Why'd my timer go away? Where is my timer? Oh, it hasn't been, okay. It hasn't been set yet, so. Wow. Okay. Well, this is getting to the difficult part. Okay, no drift. A little drift. You can do it without drifting. If I had more time, I think I would prevent that from being able to happen. But I really just want, see, there's my drift. Why is it not setting back to false? If drift is held while 800 speed, yeah, that could work. Let's try that out. Compare speed is greater than, let's say 700, give it a little pad. Car speed, and then I know I want that sub event to that. I don't know if we need this anymore. So, well, this is the part that's not working. And I don't understand why. Because we're setting it to true in a triggered event. So that's the only time it gets set true. And then when it is true, let's try something out. Let's try a trigger once while true and see if that works. There it is. So it was every frame of the game, it was setting it to true. I needed to just get it done once. Okay. All right. So there is a little bit of a penalty there for not using drift. It's definitely harder to control, but that's, I think if I increase the speed, max speed of the car, come on. I do like that drift though. Okay, so now we know when it's drifting. That was a good idea. I was willing to try that out, but I've run into this issue with trigger once so many times that finally popped right back into my head. Glad I got that figured out. Okay, now we know when we're drifting. Let's go to... eventually make a power bar that fills when you don't drift and you need... Yes, I think that is what I should have started with. And... I know I said we were going to make a whole game in one stream, but I think that next time... I stream that we will implement some of these ideas and improve on this game. I think that is a great, great idea, having a power bar for that. Like you said, so you can't use it so often. High five. In the back. In the back seating with the dog. All right. So, I would like to create a drift zone. Let's see. We might not want that, but I'll try it. Let's call this drift zone. We'll put it down there. And on drift zone, I'm going to get a sprite. And I'll just make this something like 100 by 100. Let's put that bottom left. That's good. I'm going to just give it a color and check that it's good. And what do I want? Opacity. Let's drop that down like 40%. And And then, I don't know, something like that. Drift zone. let's make a UI and parallax set 0 to 0. And I'm going to put some text. Arial, that's fine. Size. That's a lot. Let's go 30 and make it white so we can see it. And bold, because why not? Left, center. No, that's fine. Top left, it's great. Great. Okay. Was the extinction game my art? No, it was not. I have all the credit for that written somewhere. I think it's actually in the project file, but no. It was not. I am not that artistic. Okay, there's our text. well, the bomb was my art. I'm trying to think of what I had. Cloud. Jams. What was that? Was that Xander Jam? Hey, thank you. Appreciate it. Is Xander Jam 5. I do appreciate that. I worked a full week. In fact, I think I had that week off, and I was just sitting at home just working on this game way too long every day. But let's see. I made the bomb. I made the clock, which is not really, not really art. I made all the hints. Really, it's just the tile maps that I did not make, which was the platform objects, and then the background was the sky. Other than that, I think everything in here is mine, except for the dinosaur. I did recolor the dinosaur, and man, I forgot about all this. It's been a while. this was done very quickly, and is the ladder system does not work if there's more than I think more than two ladders in a level, or maybe it's more than one ladder in a level. So that's why I made that that tutorial video not too long ago about a ladder system that takes care of all of that. But it was a fun project. It was a good jam. I had a lot of fun with that. Xanderwood did a great job with that. Okay. Let's say drifts. Is that, I can't even see that. Is that okay? It's very tiny on my screen. Or I've just told too many dad jokes and I can't see that well anymore.
Haha. Yeah.
Comes full circle. All right. Sorry for the distraction.
Nah.
Stream Elements. Man, you can't trust Stream Elements. I've learned that the hard way. And I still not really sure how to work it. Although it's doing a lot better job this round than it was last week. Let's see. I want to set that every time we drift. So, let's say when our car is overlapping our drift zone and we are drifting. So let's go to our car, get that Boolean is drifting. And then I'm going to sub event that one more time. Okay, I'm going to need another variable here. I'll call this drift points. Fantastic. Is drifting. I need to trigger once while true. And I will add two drift points. Now let's just make it 5. Make it seem like we're accomplishing something. And add 5 to drift points. And then I will need to set our text to drifts space is the ampersand. Is that right? And then drift points. I believe that is true. Okay, and I'm going to need to set that at the beginning as well, because it won't set the text. Oh, wait, no. I need on start a layout. Start. What am I doing? Add event. Start of layout. Move you to the top. And copy that up to there. Let's play that. Drifts 0. Okay. That worked. Cool. Not bad. Haha. So it doesn't do it any other time other than when I'm drifting through the zone. I cheated it right there. Okay. This is where your suggestion for the speed comes into play. I think that, say you have to be going a certain speed, because I just drifted at a very slow speed and it counted it. So I'm going to say greater than, and then we'll do, let's do that 700. We'll put it there. Then we'll check to see, and I think that can go in any order there. I like that. And there we go. I'll test this out. See, I drifted through that. You got to strap the dog in. Unless it's my dog, then she has to sit in your lap because... See, I wasn't going as fast through that, and it didn't count it. Yeah, my dog is 8 pounds and very tiny with stubby legs. I should check on her. Hold on just a second. And I woke her up. What a jerk.
I'm sorry, baby. I'm sorry.
Oh, poor girl. Just not feeling well. Okay. Let's add some more of these little guys on the corners. Make that a little smaller. Her stomach's been upset today. It's very, very noisy. She's a Chihuahua, and Chihuahuas are kind of bottom feeders. They'll eat anything. Hope she feels better soon. Me too. Thank you very much. Me too. I hate seeing her like this, but she's old, and she's doing really well, though. Today's not been a good day. I'm sure it'll pass by tomorrow, and she'll probably gorge herself until she's sick to her stomach again. Nah, it's all right. I don't feed her a whole lot at one time. Try not to. It's also very hard to not give her tons of treats, because when an adorable little dog just stares at you, it's hard to not just give them all the treats they want. But I'm a sucker for dogs, so. All right. That should drifts zero. Ooh. Oh. Yeah, see, I didn't get points for that. That was a good drift. We'll have to redesign the track to take better advantage of drifts. And see, I kind of like that because I didn't drift through that corner. Didn't drift through that one either. But I tried to cut the corner, so... I didn't get the points for it. I kind of like how that worked. Cool. All right, we can fine tune this. I think the base project that we have right here looks pretty good. Not bad. Does she eat quickly? Yes, she eats very fast. She doesn't eat as fast as she used to because we used to have three dogs, and when you put the food in their bowl down on the floor, they wanted to eat as fast as they could, and then they go check each other's bowls. But our other two passed away in the last few months, and after a couple of weeks, she got used to being the only dog, and now sometimes she goes and takes a couple bites and then runs to the next room, and she knows nobody's going to go steal her food, so. But when she does actually sit there and eat her food, she scarfs it down as quickly as she can. She's afraid it's going to grow some legs and walk off. But again, she's a very typical Chihuahua. She eats worms in the backyard after it rains. And all the worms come up out of the ground. She'll go out there and eat the worms, but they have to be dead. She won't eat live ones. And we had her on steroids for a condition she had a while back.
a couple years back, and a dog on steroids eats and drinks constantly. And she would go outside and do her business and then eat it. Sorry for being gross there, but that's a Chihuahua. They are bottom feeders. But they're adorable as can be. Extra air from eating fast? It could be. Yeah. Because I don't think me or the wife have fed her anything that would upset her stomach. So it very well could be that. Yeah, I hope that's it too. I'm pretty sure she'll be good by tomorrow, or maybe even later tonight. I don't know. As long as she's still breathing, I'm let her just sit there and rest and do her thing. Okay. Let's see here. So, I mean, we have an objective, and it works pretty well. And I think we should continue this in another stream and keep building on it, because I really thought this was just going to be a kind of practice with it when we started with the car behavior, but I really like it. I think there's a lot can be done with this car behavior that I don't have to code in, which is nice. So, all right. I think that's going to do it for me tonight. I think I've been on for quite a while now. You had a dog about a week ago that you needed to train that eats too fast and wasn't feeling good enough to train because of it. Yeah. Yeah. I think dogs just naturally eat really quick that I've noticed. I don't know. She always eats so fast, but I don't know. She takes medicines too. It could be the combination, stuff sitting on her stomach, and I don't know. Feel like this game could go a long way? I do too. I think there's a lot of other features we can put into it that'll make it fun to play, and I would like to venture into some multiplayer at some point, see if we can do that. Your dog eats slow? Really? What kind of dog do you have? Is it a bigger dog, or? I've never had a very large dog. I've had a lot of dogs, but they've all been dogs that can easily fit in your lap. A German Shepherd. Oh, that's awesome. Those are beautiful dogs. Yeah, so a little bit bigger dog. A little bit. Quite a bit bigger than this 8-pound thing down here. Huh. Eat slow. I guess I just don't know enough about dogs' eating habits. That's interesting. All right. How old is your German Shepherd? Out of curiosity. I'm going to rename this track. One. 1.5? Oh, still a little bitty baby. Not really, but that's pretty young. Lot of energy in that age of a dog, huh? I can't believe it's 1.5 and it eats slow. That just baffles me. That's crazy. It's cool though. Good for. Yeah. A lot of energy. Let's see here. I'm going to move that above that. Okay.
All right. I think I'm going to end the stream here. Q Merc, I appreciate all your help as usual. You were a huge help last week, and you continued to be a great help tonight. When's the next stream? I want to say either Monday or Tuesday night. I want to say. Because those are going to be my best opportunities to do it again until next weekend. I don't want to tell you something and then, you know, not do it. So I want to try for Monday or Tuesday, or Monday and Tuesday if I can manage that. Otherwise, I'm going to try again next Friday. And then I wanted to get on last night, but my condition in my nose was still hitting me pretty hard. And I had headaches and all that stuff. And it's just every spring, I'm allergic to pretty much everything. Every spring, when the weather just starts to get a little bit warmer, everything starts blooming around here. And I have a garden out in the backyard, and it's got lots of flowers that are starting to come up, and I'm allergic to all of it, and it flows through the air, and the wind picks up. It's really windy here, and I get feeling like this, and I'm pretty useless for like a month. So hopefully in a couple of weeks I'll be feeling great. I'll have more karma if I don't. That's fair. That's fair, and I believe you. We've established that tonight. Hey, I appreciate it. Thank you. I'll be fine. If you ask my wife, I just whine a lot more than I actually feel bad. So she's probably right. All right, man. I'm gonna get off of here. Everybody else that came in tonight, I certainly appreciate it. Like I was just saying, I'm going to try to get back on Monday or Tuesday, or hopefully both. So I'll definitely send that out on all the socials and here on YouTube as well ahead of time. And that is going to do it for me tonight. Hey, thanks, Q Merc. We'll see you next time. I appreciate it. You have a good one, too. All right, everybody. What button am I trying to push? Oh, there we go. All right. Have a good one.